Let the Lord of the Black Land come forth!
My master's
explicit critics
bids thee welcome.
Really, nigga?
What's happening? It's Explicit Critics. So we're here for this gameplay trailer. And it actually, nah, this ain't a trailer. It's a walkthrough. Because this shit is mad long. 16 fucking minutes? We're gonna get right into it because it's long as fuck. But if you like comic book movies, we just reviewed Logan. Go peep that. If you want to see people that talk about Wolverine and know about Wolverine, there's your guy right there.
Some of the crowd's been saying this, like being said right now.
Yeah. Also, if you're big Lord of the Rings fans, we have a reaction to Te Lord of Te Rings. And that shit was fucking hilarious. We'll have one more video up this week. Make sure to go peep their channel. We'll keep doing reactions because the editors want us to react to their videos. They're fucking hilarious.
Yeah, they're spot on.
Also, this game for me has a lot riding on this trailer because if it's nice enough,
be the best Lord of the Rings game.
If it's nice enough, it might make me buy the Mithril Edition. $300. $300 motherfucking dollars.
What does it come with? Like a fucking shrine?
It comes with a bunch of gimmicks. So it's either they're gonna get $100 from me with the gold edition that comes with like all the DLC shit, or $300. And I'm not even one of those dudes that likes the collectibles that comes with it. But some of the shit that I was reading was so dope, I'm like, if this is a good enough trailer, I'ma cop it.
$300 worth.
I mean, we spent that much on Marvel Heroes and we didn't even use it.
That's true.
And they didn't even come with anything.
$200, yeah.
Alright.
Yeah, so we'll see. Got the shit early though. That's basically
it. Yeah, that's true. I don't know, we'll see.
Shadow of War is an epic third-person open-world action RPG and the sequel to the award-winning Shadow of Mordor. This walkthrough takes place many hours into the game, where we will show you one example of the epic personal stories created through the next generation of the revolutionary Nemesis System. To save Middle-earth, we will be journeying deep behind enemy lines and using the new Ring of Power to forge an army and conquer Mordor from within. On the world map, we see the many regions we can conquer. Every one of these regions is a distinct environment with unique enemies and allies, including overlords, war chiefs, captains, followers, fortresses, strongholds, missions, and more. Today, we're going to attack and conquer the mountain valley of Seregost and take it from Sauron's overlord, Ur-Hakon, the Dragon Lord.
Damn.
Let's launch the assault.
Yo, there is so many places you can go in this one. Way more.
Shit, far as fuck.
You get to fucking siege places like this? Yo.
And the world that make the Nemesis System unique, it's also our followers. Rob Duke the Iron Mount has armored cavalry that can charge through the flames of artillery fire. The Demolisher is a living battering ram with the power to smash enemy defenses. With our followers at our side, we must first face the storm.
I was reborn with the power of the Dark Lord.
He has a history and personal grudge against us. He used to be part of our army.
Disables
the ring
of power
and joined the Dark Lord. He also carries a dark curse which prevents us from using the power of the new ring.
Charge into the flames of your reckoning.
Overlord has deployed multiple fort defenses,
damn,
including siege beasts and flame archers.
No more
dish is water.
Yo, that's a fat army. He stays his back while everybody just fucked up over here.
Our first objective will be to break through the main gate.
For real, they did get fucked up.
Everybody got fucked up. Yo. Oh shit, you can get hit by that shit too. That's probably.
Yo, everybody's fucking scored.
Damn, no one even got past the fucking.
He did, big dude, demolisher. He's
attacking that door.
I feel like they should have been trying to take him down. Nobody.
Yeah, we got one wall.
Oh, no. It seems like he's attacking quicker or something.
Oh, he got his shit!
Try to grab him. He's bitching him though.
Damn. Hey.
Ooh.
He flips it.
Shit, man.
The Stormbringer defeated. We've broken the curse and can unleash our power. As the Demolisher breaches the gate, allowing our army to storm the fort.
Fuck! Damn! Bolt smash? Rip his motherfucking head off. In the first one, couldn't you blow up fires or some shit? Yo,
shit.
Yo, there's a lot of peeps in here.
Ways to conquer a fort, from open combat to stealth and infiltration.
Yo!
Oh, no!
Oh, shit! That was sick!
He's in the middle of slit and throat and then killed him.
He brought him over there?
That's dope.
We've infiltrated a spy.
What's up,
bug? Get over here!
Deadeye has placed explosives, allowing us to sabotage the wall and outflank the defenders.
Damn. Oh, beehive? I'm not even about that shit. Oh, nigga wasn't dead?
Cheated dead. Hey! That's hard as fuck, yeah.
The spy is also able to help clear the way by sniping enemies. In Shadow of Mordor, the Nemesis system created memorable stories of bloodshed and revenge. In Shadow of War, your followers can create entirely new stories of loyalty, betrayal, rivalry, and even friendship.
Damn.
That's dope.
Gotcha. That's a dope ass crossbow.
Damn.
Headshot.
First shot.
We've expanded the RPG systems in Shadow of War enormously.
Take this shit.
Defeating Stormbringer allows us to collect this epic armor of Rohan and equip it.
Hey, that shit looks hard. Gold fucking shit.
Stormbringer, he was mine, and
start booking it.
Yo, oh damn.
Oh my god, flamethrowers everybody.
Shit.
Jeez, called that shit?
Cavalry allows us to ride through these flames unharmed.
How though? You should burn this shit up.
Maybe he's immune to fire.
Hey, that's hard. That's like a bronze flamethrower.
What's the dragon?
Yo!
I think it was
inside.
Oh,
it was inside?
Yeah.
That's dope. No.
What?
Hey.
Releasing and dominating the drake
Skyrim
lets us turn the Overlord's defenses against him.
Whoa, dope.
They even reach down.
Damn.
It goes fucking far.
I wonder if there's gonna be any like full size dragons, not just drakes like this. Just small size one. Damn.
Shit.
Smack.
I got bitch slapped.
Oh, look at that neck though.
Yeah. Grab his neck and then. No.
Yeah.
No.
You've terrified the flame of war. Now bend him to your will. The ring of power allows us to dominate the minds of our enemies.
I am yours,
compelling them to join our growing army. Now, with the power of the new ring and the help of our followers, we've defeated the war chiefs.
Yeah, he was a little bitch.
Oh, so there's gonna be like a couple war chiefs per fortress, probably. He's just taking it.
We can face our ultimate nemesis in this fort, the Dragon Lord himself.
It's time to take what is ours.
With the Nemesis system, every overlord faced by every player will be unique to their world, and the throne room itself has been customized by the overlord as his personal combat arena.
It's the Lord of Mordor himself, the Gravewalker. You've made a right mess, haven't you? My army slain. My drake dead. So much pain.
Damn.
I know what the mortal do about pain. And yours.
The drake
spawn burn a hole into this world.
Shit. Shit. Oh shit. Yo, he's dismembering fucking everybody. Throwing his own dudes at him.
Damn.
Ooh,
you know, life in that shit.
This might hurt.
Shit, you know, life right there.
Yo, he banged him. He banged it.
He took a knee.
Shit.
Ooh, no arm.
Overlord defeated, Fort Seregost, and this region of Mordor are ours. Conquering the region rewards us with experience, loot, new followers, and resources. It also creates a personal base from which we train our forces, increase our power, and upgrade our defenses against Sauron's counterattacks.
Oh, let's go.
Let's return to the army screen, where we can review our enemies and command our followers. We need to select one to become the new Overlord, so he can spread his influence throughout the region, creating an entirely original Nemesis fortress. This war chief is a threatening monster. He will shroud the fort in sorcery to confuse and terrify attackers. This war chief is a beastmaster. He will allow us to turn the creatures of Mordor
against our enemies.
That looks
like the fucking orcs from Warcraft.
But we're going to promote Ravdug, the war chief who charged through that artillery assault and helped us bring down Ord Hakon, the Dragon Lord. As a marauder, he can loot and pillage the region for us.
Damn.
With our new overlord in place, we can upgrade the fortress, increasing its defenses and enlarging the size and power of our army. The Nemesis system means that every element of this mission was dynamic and unique. No two players of the game will experience the same story.
We will spread his power!
This was just one step in our conquest of Mordor. One small example of the millions of unique stories players will create in Middle-earth Shadow of War.
Damn, that's so many spots you can take. Shit.
For the Bright Lord.
Well, yeah, I don't know.
All right. I'm copping the Mithril. That was dope enough.
That was just pretty dope.
Fuck, man. Alright, so yeah, I bought that shit. That shit looked dope as fuck. The only thing, well, I can't criticize because it wasn't in there, but I'm hoping, and I know it probably won't be in there, just some type of multiplayer.
Oh.
Because it would be so hard to take down a fortress like one of your dudes. It would be easy to implement. They could just have like the second player be one of the orcs or something.
Yeah, but not split screen. It'd be a
no.
Console to console.
Yeah, not split screen. I don't think they'll put that in there though. Especially because they're like, oh, every single instance is gonna be unique to the player. So that doesn't make for a multiplayer game. Either way, that looked fucking dope. And that's coming from somebody that literally played almost none of the first one.
First was dope shit. They had like fucking the risk element and stuff like that.
This seemed like way better though, right?
Yeah, that's okay. A lot better. There's just more to do because after a while the first one did kind of get bored.
Yeah, that's what I heard. Even though I'm going to replay it right now, I have it on Gamefly. So I'm going to try to get through it before this comes out, which I have a good amount of time. So. Fuck though, you can ride on fucking drakes.
That's dope. That's so dope.
And that's, I mean, they said this is only a couple or a few hours into the game. Something like that. So you know there's going to be way more shit. Because this is just fighting, I don't want to say regular people, but if you get to fight like the Nazgul and Sauron and all those dudes, the battle's going to have to be so much more epic. I think it's even going to be dope. You know, once you claim a fortress, you have to protect it from counterattacks. That's going to be hard.
Yeah, I have to go back.
That's going to be so dope.
And it's based on like who you promote and
shit. Yeah. All right, so if there's any other videos that comes out from Warner Brothers, we'll react, but I don't know if you can top that shit.
That would be nice.
I would be totally fine if they just left it
they
that
should.
Until
they
August.
Like that. That's a long... That's just, yeah, it was this playthrough.
Yeah, that's a long... And it explained everything, yeah. So... All right, we'll catch you next time, Exclusive Critics.
What's good? It's your boy, Mooks.
Hey, it's Stacy's mom.
Yes, sir.
fucking god.
Yes, sir!